Today, I will talk about the scientific basis of piezo computers. A computer uses a binary system to store and process data. In current computers, we use transistors to create that binary system. In a simple language, a transistor can have two states. It is either off or on, which corresponds to 0 and 1 in the computer language. In piezo computers, we use a piezoelectric cell to create a binary system. We apply a voltage to the cell, and depending on how we remove the voltage, we can have two distinct states, which corresponds to 0 and 1 in computers. This graph shows the process. I repeated the experiments 3 times to make sure the system is repeatable and stable. An electric voltage is used to write the information. When we remove the voltage, we have two possible states. One of them is considered as state 0, and the other would be state 1. We wrote a proposal to the National Science Foundation, and we got a $500,000 fund to continue this research. I will leave a link to that proposal in the description box below this video. You can download it if you like more details. There were a lot of experimental techniques and physics behind creating this binary system. I wrote 3 patents before the US Patent and Trademark Office to cover the different aspects of this technology. The university itself had a special office for technology transfer. They evaluated the technology and concluded that the development of this technology will be rapid and even explosive. These experiments were the final part of my PhD dissertation, and they created another advantage, so that I did not need to write a dissertation manuscript. If a PhD dissertation results in more than 3 publishable papers, the university accepts those 3 papers as the dissertation manuscript. This creates more convenience, because once a student reaches that milestone, the PhD is finished and the rest is just a formality and paperwork. I should talk about the article-based dissertations in a separate video, but here I will leave a link to that document in the description box below this video. It explains how the process is done. In the next video, I will talk about another scientific basis of piezo computers. Thank you for watching.